Father, look out!
I can't talk to you right now.
Is everything more important than your sons?
Oh, no. Stu, call the police.
What? Oh, police.
Operator. Operator! Please, this is an emergency. I want the police.
No, don't touch it.
I have no choice, Tia.
Didn't the police follow you here?
We're on our own. No one knows we're here. I have to try to defuse it myself.
Yes, I'm sure it was a gunshot.
Why? It could have been a car back firing.
What? Bergman. B-E-R-G-M-A-N.
Look, if it was a shot, my father could be in danger.
Yes, I'm one of the co-owners of the restaurant. All right, I will, but hurry, will you please? Please hurry.
I want to know where my father went.
Please, not... excuse me. Adair, where have you been? Now, look, I want you out front here.
I just had to call the police, see? So I don't want the customers to get alarmed when I talk to them. So if you could keep him...
Adair, where are you going?
Travis, T.R.? Floyd Kendall, I want to help. Travis? Travis? T.R., can you hear me?
Frightened, Kate. I just keep seeing the look in Rusty's eyes before he left. You don't dwell on it. Think about the joyful chaos when he comes back with T.R.
It will be joyful, won't it? Look. Can I ever show you the pictures that T.R. drew of the family?
They're so true to life.
Mm-hmm. She really pays attention to detail. Look at the twinkle in Granddad's
smile. Oh, yes, and she certainly knows your smile.
Well, a stranger wouldn't have picked up on that. It's as if she's always been with us. Kate, we're going to adopt her. We've already started proceedings.
I'm not surprised. When you mention T.R., I hear the pleasure in your voice.
Do I sound like her mother?
When you adopt T.R., you'll only be making legal what is already an emotional truth.
Rusty can't wait to be your father. They really do love each other so much.
What?
Oh. That was the first picture T.R. ever drew.
Why did she tear it up?
Well, when Rusty had that sudden trip to the Orient, I don't know, she felt he'd left her. She was hurt, she was angry, she was frightened. Kate, they have to be saved. They have to be. You know what? Rusty's gonna teach T.R. to spell father. And he is gonna find her. They're gonna be so happy, and the only thing I'm gonna be sad about is that I'm not there to see that reunion. Then when we're all together again, she's gonna draw a brand new picture of him. And she's gonna write his name in big letters right across the top.
Travis, is it okay to talk now?
I've been wanting to hear your voice since you were kidnapped. You better talk quietly. This is pretty tricky work.
You need to hear yourself think?
That's right.
How do you know what to do?
I've overseen a lot of different projects at T.I. So I know a little something about detonators.
When I grow up, I want to be as smart as you.
Well, you're pretty smart already.
No. Being dumb is what got us into this mess in the first place.
That's not true, T.R. You were smart enough to leave your ring for us to find. That's how we knew what happened.
Yeah, I always thought that ring would bring me luck. But it didn't help Sonny at the trial. I was wearing it when I got kidnapped.
Well, if it wasn't a lucky ring, then how did I find you? It's a labyrinth down here, but I found...
I knew you would. And I told that to Warren Carter and his friend.
I hope they didn't hurt you.
Well, they were too busy hurting each other. But you know, Warren wasn't so bad. He even beat up that Ringo guy because of me.
Where is Warren now?
I don't know. But it was Ringo who made up the trouble. He kept saying that he might not pay to get me back.
Why did he say that?
Because he knew I'm not your real daughter. And I'm not even adopted, so he figured you wouldn't care what happened to me.
And he figured wrong.
Don't be angry. Oh, I'm sorry, I've been talking too much and you can't concentrate.
Angry. The only thing I'm angry about is that I haven't talked to you enough. There are so many things I haven't had a chance to say. And now I have to worry about wires and connectors. And all I want to do is hold you in my arms and tell you how much I love you.
It's all right. Wolf kind of got her hands full. Oh, I wish I could hug you. You know how much I love you back?
I do know. I see it in your eyes and I hear it every time you talk to me.
I wasn't sure you could tell. I'm not really used to showing my feelings. But I'll always know how you and Liza feel about me.
You do?
Yes. That's what I was trying to draw in my pictures. The way Liza's mouth curls up when she's pleased with me. The way your eyes will narrow all of a sudden. Because you can't always keep things from hurting me.
I'm glad you understand that, Tia. Because when people have nothing left in the whole world, loving and being loved still makes it all worth living.
Alana and Turner know how much you love them, too. But they can't tell you now because they don't know how to talk yet. But when they do, you know what they'll say?
What?
Liza is the best mother anyone could ever want. And you're the best father. Travis teaches me how to spell father.
F-A-G-H.
F A T H E R.
Perfect.
My father is perfect.
Just give us the story and fast.
Oh, all right, Travis. Travis came here.
Was he carrying the briefcase with the ransom?
Yes, yes. I turned my back for 1 minute and he was gone.
Gone? What do you mean gone? Where is he?
I don't know. You see, there was an envelope left on the bar. It was addressed to Travis. One of my waitresses found it, gave it to him, and he disappeared.
Stu, you reported a gunshot.
Yes, I think it came from below.
Well, that makes sense. Carter knows this place like the back of his hand.
Look, what makes you think this was a gunshot?
Because I heard it, and so did Lloyd Kendall.
Kendall? What was Kendall doing here?
Well, he was trying to help.
Oh, I don't believe this. Everybody's a cop. Where's Kendall now?
He's trying to find them.
Well, this is great. Now we have three lives at stake.
Stu, look, you're going to have to empty the restaurant. We think they have a bomb.
A bomb?
All right, look, don't panic the customers. Just go table to table, nice and easy. Ask people to leave.
Well, how am I going to do it, please? All right. Kendall, the kids, and Tell. We'll have to cordon off this whole area. There may be more shooting, and if that bomb blows, come on.
Adair, you in there? Adair.
Go away.
I come in peace. Could I have some wine for my camel? She doesn't drink much. You want to take a ride? She has two humps.
One for you and one for your brother?
The brother isn't with me. It's just me and the camel.
I don't see any camel.
Must have been a mirage. That's the problem with the desert. Never can trust what you see. What happened, Adair? I tried to find you everywhere. I started to think you had been a mirage. I called your house, talked to your mother.
What did you tell her?
She thought you were at school.
And you told her I wasn't.
No, I didn't want to worry her. I went to your roommate. She didn't want to tell me anything. I insisted. So she finally showed me a letter from you. At least I knew you were all right. Why, Adair? We were so close.
I told you. I don't feel that way anymore.
I accepted that. Even though I didn't understand it, I honored your wishes. And then you dropped out of school, vanished into thin air.
I wasn't making it. My grades were falling and I couldn't face it.
I would have helped you.
I didn't want to see you.
Did I do something to hurt you?
No. Alec, you never hurt me. Don't ever think that.
Well, then why didn't you want to see me?
Because it's over. There was no point.
I'll be in Henderson for a while. Do you think we could be friends? I don't want to embarrass you. I promise never to bring my camel to your house.
Is your brother in Henderson, too?
No. Chase is in Bedford right now. So how about it? Buddy-buddy, hamburger and ice cream soda friends?
Well, I don't know if it would be such a good idea.
You don't even have to like me. I can live on scorn.
What about your camel?
Two's company, three's a crowd.
Hamburgers and scorn, huh?
Friends?
You can't see.
Turner starts to pull on the crib bars. I always know that he wants his mama to play with.
Oh, is that right? How long has that been going on?
Well, ever since you brought that Indonesian doll into the nursery, remember? You stuck its little head in through the crib bars and made it say hello to Turner.
Uh-huh.
That's his favorite game now.
Oh, is that right? Is that right? That's your favorite game. Is that your favorite game?
Your daddy brought you that toy, didn't he?
Little leaguer. Your daddy brought you that beautiful toy from the
Orient. Yes, he did. Oh, goodness.
Oh,
look at you. Your daddy loves you so much. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Did I ever tell you? Did I ever tell you your daddy brought you into the world?
There we were, speeding down the mountainside, in a car without any brakes, and we crashed. Yes, we did. And you decided to come early. Oh, my goodness. I was scared. But your daddy wasn't. He said, oh, no. This baby is special. He said, you're special. You only want your mommy and your daddy in attendance for your birth. That's what he said. Then when I heard your first cry, saw the look on your daddy's face. Well, I said, God's in his heaven. All's right with the world. Then you know what we did? We went up in a helicopter. A helicopter ride all the way to the hospital. Yes. Now, isn't this something, Rusty's son? Already spreading his wings. But no matter, because as far as those wings take him, they'll always bring him home. Yes, I know that, just like his daddy. Your daddy's gonna come home.
Travis?
T.R.?
bet Liza's worried because we aren't back yet.
Waiting's the hardest thing of all.
Oh, but she'll be so happy when we get home. Oh, Travis, let's ring the bell so she has to come to the door.
D.R., it's Lloyd Kendall. Can you hear me?
Yes. We're in here, Lloyd.
You all right? You know what you're doing with that?
I'll be fine. Just free T.R. and get her out of here fast.
Where are the keys?
Ringo had it in his pocket.
He's just outside the door. Dead.
Travis, please let Mr. Kendall help you with the bomb.
Mr. Kendall's going to take you out of here. I'll be as long as just as soon as I'm through.
No, I won't leave you.
Hurry, Lloyd. Get her out of here fast.
Travis, you've got to come with us.
I will, T.R., I promise, but I can't take my finger off the detonator. The bomb will explode.
Please, Mr. Kendall, help my father.
That's right, T.R., I am your father. So listen to me, because I love you with all my heart.
I love you, too.
Then go with Lloyd, please.
No! You didn't teach me how to spell daughter yet.
No, just as soon as I get out.
No, Travis, I'm afraid. You've got to teach me now.
Just take her out of here, Lloyd.
No, I won't leave you.
Damn it, Lloyd, get her out of here. This bomb could blow up the boat.
No, Travis, I love you. I won't go.
Good luck.
No, Travis, no.
I'll send help, Dad, as soon as
Travis.
I get her out.
Daughter. D. A. U. G. H. T.
Don't look at me like that. You make it so difficult.
I'm sorry. I forgot. No love. Just scorn. Doesn't smile in the face of scorn. Such a great smile, though. And that smile of yours lights up all the dark places in my heart.
I don't believe in dark places.
Why? They're all around us. We're even in one right now. Adair. From darkness comes light. I'll always love you.
Might do it.
Let's go of it! No! Oh, I want my father! Daddy! Daddy! You loving God, I hate you! You left him there all alone when he needed your help! Let me go! Oh, Daddy, I'm coming!
We do have all night. And the night's just begun.
Shake, rattle, and roll to today's biggest hits with today's hottest dancers. It's a fast-breaking half-hour special that'll make you jump. Then on Family Ties, can the Keatons help a divorced couple settle a custody battle, or will they wind up with a battle of their own? Then Cheers gets cleaned out in a dirty poker game, and Night Court is back in session. Later on Hill Street Blues, will Bobby go down for the count when he takes on the champ? Be there.